Hello there. This video is the fifth and final video in a series of tutorials of the path effects in Inkscape. In this video, we'll take a look at all the path effects inside of the final group, labeled as experimental. In the description, I'll leave you a list with all the path effect tutorials. Make sure to check it out. Also, don't forget to like and subscribe for more tutorials on Inkscape and illustration. Angle bisector will create a path that is in the exact middle of the angle made by the first three nodes. I would like to remind you that the first three nodes refers to the first nodes you place. If your path has more than three nodes, the effect will ignore them and will only use the first three ones. This will repeat with most of these mathematical effects in the experimental category that only use a few of the nodes of the path. Very important, this effect and most of the effects that we're going to see in this category will destroy the original path when the effect is applied. So just so you can see better what you're doing, I strongly recommend you to leave enabled the option Show Path Outlines in the tool controls of the node tool. This effect don't care about the shape of the segments. They can be curved. The angle is calculated based on the position of the nodes only. Once applied, you can still move the shape of the path and the angle bisector will adapt to the new angle. With these two options, you control where does the angle bisector start and where does it ends. Extrude lets you make a plane out of a single line. You control the angle and distance with this diamond over here. You can use it with a closed shape, but doesn't work that well because of the direction of the nodes. So you want to use it mostly to transform lines into planes. Parallel will create a stroke parallel to the line made by the first and last node of your path. The path has to be open for the effect to be able to generate the stroke. After applied, you can move the nodes in your path, and the generated stroke will adapt. Notice that all the other nodes in between are completely ignored. The only thing that matters here are the first and last node you drew. This is something that you will see repeated in some of the upcoming path effects. You can move the location of the line with the white diamond, and you can control the length of the left and right side with these input boxes. Circle will create a circle using the first node of the path as the center and the final node as the length of the radius. No options in the path effect dialog. You control the width by changing the radius, moving either the first or final node. Fill between strokes will take a path and create a fill for two open paths. This effect is identical to the effect we saw previously, fill between many, from the generate category, but even more limited because it doesn't work between more than two open paths like fill between many. I would recommend you to skip this effect and use that one instead. Perpendicular bisector will just create a perpendicular line between the first and last node of the path. Just like with the other effects, it will completely ignore all the nodes in between and the shape of the segments. You can control its length from the left and right side with the path effect options. Circle by 3 points will create a circle using the first three nodes in the path. The circle's circumference will adjust to the position of the first three nodes in real time, and like before, it will ignore all the other nodes after that. No options in the path effect dialog. Line segment will create a line between the first and last node of the path. In the path effect dialog options, you have this dropdown that lets you select how the line will be shown. Close will make the line go from node to node. Open both, open left and open right, will make the line go past the nodes. Sadly, there is no way to edit its length like with previous path effects. Tangent will create a line that's tangent to a curve in your path. The path can have multiple segments and be open or closed. Once applied, you move the location of the tangent with the little diamond in the center, and the length with the diamonds in the extremes. Using location along curve, you can be more specific with where you want it. The number goes from 0 to the number of segments and works a bit like percentages. So 0.5 will place it in the exact center of the first segment, and 1.5 will place it in the exact center of the second segment, no matter the length. You can also offset the angle with the angle input box. And we are finally done with all path effects, even the experimental ones. I hope these videos were helpful in any way, or at least that they show you something you didn't know about. Path effects are an amazingly powerful feature in Inkscape, and sadly are a bit obscure by the way they are implemented. I would like to remind you that I make tutorials every week, mostly on Inkscape and also illustration, so subscribe and hit the bell if that's something interesting to you. I would highly appreciate any like and comment, it really helps me and the channel grow. Have a great day, bye!